Hey guys, welcome to my tutorial on how to make a rubber stamp with a CNC machine using ArtCam from Autodesk. Let's get started. Once you have ArtCam open, we're going to go ahead and click on New Model. Define our dimensions of our project. Let's go ahead and hit OK. We go to Bitmaps, right click on Bitmap Layer and go to Import. And select a graphic. I found that like clip art style graphics work really well because there's like a high contrast between white and black. I'll go ahead and choose a stormtrooper. Don't forget to choose the scaling option. We're gonna do fit. There we go. Nice stormtrooper. And the next step we're gonna do is convert our imported bitmap into a vector. And you just click on bitmap to vector, which is right here. And it pops up a dialog box. And at the bottom of the screen, you'll see a list of all the colors it detects. It's every variant between black and white because it's compensating for all those pixels in the image here. So all those little pixels are a slightly different shade. So you have to make sure that we reduce those, the number of colors here of your image. And that's just simply clicking the button here, reduce colors, and you define how many colors you want to have. As you scroll this slider, you'll see the colors at the bottom continually diminish until we're left with two. Just hit apply. And the rest of the items are fine. You might, if you have some images with a lot of sharp corners and stuff, you may want to adjust the smoothness. And just hit create vectors. And there you go. It's a bit hard to see with the black vectors on a black image. You can adjust the bitmap visibility with the slider here. It makes things a little easier. And the first thing you do after you create your vectors is you have to make sure, this is very important, you have to make sure you flip the image over and mirror it, or else when you create your stamp and stamp with it, it's going to be backwards. This is especially important with text, so do not forget this step. Flip your graphics horizontally. And the way you do that, you select all your vectors, go to Edit, Mirror, and it pops up a dialog box like this. And make sure copy the original objects. I think that's checked by default. Make sure that's unchecked. We're going to do horizontal on center. So this is kind of the line that flips it around. So we'll go ahead and hit center, close that. And we're going to close our bitmap, or hide our bitmap. There we go. The next step is for us to define the area within your design that's going to be cut out by ArtCam. Anything that's black, we're going to leave raised, and anything white, it's going to cut away. So we're going to hide our bitmap, turn our vectors that we mirrored back on, and click on Create Rectangle, and we're going to draw a box around our Stormtrooper, like so. And make sure it's a big box. It can be outside the bounds of your workpiece. We're going to adjust that in a moment. And make sure you hit Create. And we're going to adjust the size of this guy just a little bit to make him fit in our workpiece dimensions a little better. If the graphic goes right to the edge, the V-bit is going to have a hard time getting in there. It can't physically fit in this area to cut. It's going to be not easy for it. So in order to help that, we're going to shrink our graphic just a little bit. You could also make the workpiece size bigger if you adjust the set size here. That'll make the white area bigger. We're just going to shrink them just a little bit. Select everything, go to Edit, and Transform. If you hover the mouse cursor over the corner, it'll allow you to scale it. And as you can see, it's bound to the corner. So it scales based on the right corner. You can actually scale based on the center of your design by holding the Alt key while adjusting your mouse. So we're just going to shrink that just a little bit to get some clearance.
We have clearance, Clarence.
Roger, Roger. What's our vector, Victor?
around the graphic. The next thing we're going to do, we're going to go to create VBit carving toolpath, which is there. The start depth is 0, as long as your material that you're surfacing or that you're cutting is completely flat, then that can be 0. We'll adjust the maximum depth. I found that 0.08 inches is a good depth for the stamp. Select carving tool. I'm doing a 1/8 inch V-bit. I'll include a link to that in the description if you want to pick one of those up. You can click this little drop down box to edit the settings for step over and step down. So we're going to choose 0.02 for the step over and go down to define the material. Material thickness. The material I'm using is 1/4 inch thick. Hit OK. And hit calculate now. Then we're going to do a simulation based on the toolpath. Looks super cool. And here are a couple more designs. You could do a Hydra symbol, Hail Hydra, or you could prepare for the coming winter season and get a nice Game of Thrones stamp. And that's it. Quick and easy. I'm going to save this toolpath. Save toolpaths right here. Just so I remember what bit I used. 1/8 inch V bit. Go hit save. And let's go ahead and run it.